and that leads to my question, because here now you're in the student view that received the reviews. You can grade and decide if you agree with those points or not, but how do you then give points, if you want to the actual reviewers?
Okay, so give points to the reviewers. My solution was to keep track of this in just a spreadsheet. I had a spreadsheet of all their names, and I did this outside of Canvas. And then I would just say, I had three symbols, right? L was they gave too low a grade, just plus was they gave the right grade, H was too high a grade. And then if they didn't get any L or H's of all the reviews, we did like, I think five different review sessions and then one more of the final paper, then they got all the participation points. Yeah, if they had some lows and highs, they lost 5 points per time.
And so Canvas doesn't organize that for you?
Not that I know of. Now there may be a way of doing it and I don't know, but I might investigate that to see if I can figure it out. Yeah. Mm-hmm. Yes?
So you have this setup where they are grading each other based on a rubric that you provide.
Yes.
Is there a way of having them within Canvas sort of carry out specific activities? So for example, I teach a Common E class, I'm doing a lot of writing. One of the activities I have them do to peer review is not just edit each other's papers, but do something like a reverse outline, where they try to reconstruct the outline of the person's paper to see if the argument is clear. Is there a way of giving them that assignment to be done, having a place where I can see that they've done it and also look at the paper on which they did it?
Instead of just kind of grading each other? Yeah, you could. I think you could definitely do that. The way I would do that is I create an assignment, I have them upload both the other person's paper and their outline, and then you could look at those and grade them in the Canvas. It'd be quite easy to do.
So that's what I've done at the moment. They're just completely separate assignments.
Yeah. Yeah, I don't think there's a way to link them that I'm aware of. Yes?
It looks like it's on Project Radar, but it's not going to be implemented anytime soon, but it's an idea that's been proposed in the community and got 142 votes. So it's
what's that?
The being able to grade the whether or not they peer reviews, that you like the reassignment with flow, so you do the drafts, you do the reviews, you do the final.
Group them all together.
Cool. Getting involved in the Canvas community is a good way to get these concerns noted.
Yeah, one of the issues I did have with this is sometimes the rubric would not come up for people. And we reported it as a bug to Canvas. I think they might have fixed it. I'm not sure. I haven't checked. But when sometimes students, you know, whatever OS or browser combination that they have, the rubric either wouldn't come up or would come up and they couldn't get to the save button, so they couldn't record the rubric. In those cases, I just said, okay, look at what your score is, tell them what the score is, and then write comments. But yeah, that was one thing. But that was a minor bug. It only would happen if I had 100 students, it would happen to 5. So it was made more than the majority of the students got it, which is fine. Yeah.
I've been doing this for the last, just over the semester, with this issue, and been able to give the award credit as hard, so I only do it voluntarily. I found a script for scraping pages that I've been using to get data analytics on people touching pages and stuff. One of the things that you showed was a list of like students that check, you know, whether they actually review. So even just to award participation credit for that by scraping that page is probably possible, or maybe you could find someone to help with that.
When you say scraping pages, I immediately think this is complex. This is a complex thing, scraping pages and using a script. I know that it'll work for some, but others will be like, here, use a script. Ah. All right, so we have somebody for the active teaching lab next semester talking about
scraping pages.
I was going to say, as I work with this, I did it voluntarily. What I really wanted was the students to write a draft and get the feedback, incorporate the feedback, and then submit.
So the way I've solved that solution is, let's say the final report is worth 100 points. The draft is worth 20. And you get a zero, it's very likely for you to get a zero if you don't put in a full effort. So if we look at your paper and you know, I will look at all the papers I won't read them, but I'll look at them, and if your introduction is this long, blah, blah, boom, you get a zero on that, and that does motivate them to do a good job. But surprisingly, what seemed to motivate them more was showing it to one of their people, 20 people in the class, who's assigned randomly. So it's not their buddy, it's just somebody randomly in the class. And we didn't get too much problem with that. Of course, you always have some students that for whatever reason can't do a good job. You know, but they pay for it.
One way to handle that problem is to do it in Google Docs and have them actually talk about, like, metacognition, about what feedback they got and what they did to make the changes, even in a box or whatever at the top of the document that they hand in. Then as an instructor, you could, if you choose, go back in, see the revision history based on the comments, and, like, you could follow it down to that rabbit hole if you'd like.
Yeah, I don't have the resources.
Right.
But the other thing I wanted to mention, we have a lab every week. And one of the problems I come into, and it's sort of a choice. What I have been doing is they have an assignment, just as you did know, it's due now, and then voluntary basis, here's an automatic peer review and help. I'm about half of them do it, I think. I get a lot out of it. And it's not for credit. So what I would like to do is have them do it. Pentagraph is a thing. Okay, that's the final one. But I have sections, right? So, you know, and they're all at different dates. That complicates things. And it kind of stretches out the whole process.
Yeah.
You know, to the point where if they're doing a draft on a lab report and it happened like several days ago, and they need a day or two to be able to then hand that in, and then to be able to hand that in, you know. So it kind of works on the one-off. That's kind of where I was coming down to. It's like, this wouldn't work for like one, but I couldn't do this throughout the semester.
So again, that's more like, that's not Canvas, it's more like what I talked about before. And we had 7 experiments, so that's about 1 every 2 weeks. Some of them are much longer than other ones. And again, what I saw was a lot of, you know, quantity and very little improvement. The good students did well, the poor students did poor. And I took the leap of faith with Julie's convincing to say, no, have them do one report and then have smaller writing assignments. And like I said, every lab analysis, the things that they really, every student knows how to baloney their way through a introduction. So you really don't need to teach them to do that. They've learned how to do that. But what they really struggle with is taking data, presenting it in a way that's understandable, and then doing the analysis of it. And so we have them do that. They're much shorter, and I put word limits on everything. So it's like a 300 word limit on their analysis. And so they really have to get to the gist of it and analyze it. And their first ones will come, it's a 30 point assignment, their first ones will come in at 20, and by the end of the semester, everybody's around 28, 29, 30, because they understand the assignment. They've learned how to do it well and analyze well. So I've been much happier with that. And then the final report that they write averages between 90 and 100. Every one of them, all 100 students, because they understand what they need to do, they've spent time on it, and they've really learned how to write better. And if you look at the reviews that the students have written, they've said, I really feel like I write better now because of this class, et cetera, et cetera. And so I really think that helps a lot. And I encourage you to maybe look at maybe not having them do so many lab reports. And you know, I don't know your course.
Well, we have to do all of that. But apropos of that, so I've done 2 rounds on this. The first round, we had a separate ruler for every lab. Mm-hmm. And that's because we're trying to stay in sync with the materials that we're prepared by others. But one thing you might consider, and I've been thinking about it, I'll tell you the 2 things. I switched to another vetted biological lab about it. Unlike your goals, it's critical thinking. I'll share it with you. It's very nice. But I made the mistake of trying to give that one rubric for everything. Mm-hmm. And let the students figure it out and kind of grow. I think what you're doing, too, is kind of let them grow on their own criticism. As opposed to, today with this lab, you're going to work on the abstract. Mm-hmm. In this lab, you're going to work on getting that graph in there or whatever, and then we'll build the pieces.
Yeah, well, that's scaffolding, and that's a good thing.
Yeah. So So that's a, that I haven't done, scaffolding up the little pieces, like.
Yeah, and I think that we put a lot more into that because they didn't, you know, everybody says write a journal style paper, a lot of students don't know what that means. And by adding a lot more scaffolding about, this is what it is. Here, look at a real abstract. What's good about it? What makes this good? Look at it compared to this rubric. Okay, now I want you to take this data and write another abstract. And then the third time they practice for their paper, and then they've got the idea. Yeah?
I was wondering about your grading strategy. So once you have your two reviewers, and then you go in to see if they're correct, you add additional comments, and what if they're off track? How do you handle the grading for yourself when you go through there and see
okay,
the
so
reviewers gave?
It was all me,
yeah.
And I have 100 students, so I had to have a method that was quick. Mm-hmm. Right. Most of these are short, so I could go through, look at, but not really grade carefully what was there, and then I'd look at their comments. If their comments matched, that was pretty much the grade they got. And with the rubric, and with the good rubric that they had, if they both agreed, they pretty much nailed it where I would want it to be. I would go spot check some, and I would read through it carefully and make sure the scores were hitting where I wanted them to be, and so that that worked. If there was a discrepancy between grades, then I would go through and grade it. And then if I came with the person who was low, the person who was high got marked as high, you graded too high, they were notified of that, and then the score was changed. Students didn't like that. But it's like, you know, yeah, and so that's how I did it.
So the students saw the grades of the reviewers right away before you went
Yes. I had no problem with that because I told them I'm going to go back through them. And it also made them realize that, yeah, he really is going back through them, not just saying he's going back through them. And so, yeah, it's 10 points each or mm-hmm. so it wasn't a big deal. No.
Does Canvas help you with saying that a student graded too high? Did it help you notify the student? No.
No. I mean, I just emailed them. You see their name. I think you can click on it and message them there. And so I was new to Canvas. There are facilities that will help you contact students and talk to them, but I didn't know about them at the time, so I didn't use them.
No, but in the peer review system, there could be.
Yeah. I think you can click on their name, and then it will bring up a box that
asks you if you want to message them.
Message them. Okay. On
so
to the next part of the
let's talk. Let's all give. Let's give you guys a chance to see what this looks like as a student. You should all have access to the Active Teaching Lab as a student who revoked, if you were a teacher before, who revoked your teacher privileges. So on the home page, there is a link to an assignment that you can finish. And it's a very short little assignment talking about your favorite or most memorable, not necessarily favorite, memorable learning experience. And there are a couple of points and there's a rubric for it. So fill it out. Take a minute or two and do it. Make sure you make a mistake so that somebody can grade you poorly on it. Or make a lot of mistakes if you want to get an F on this. This won't be on your permanent record. And if all goes well, you should automatically afterwards get an announcement that you can review somebody else's. Didn't bring your laptops?
No.
Phone?
Has. And the other thing I'm noticing is that
students use phones these days for this.
I set the due date to 12:55, and some young whippersnappers did the assignment even before they came today, so I couldn't change. Apparently it won't let you change anything once completed assignments are in.
Okay. So that means that everybody's going to be late?
Well, right. First of all, that's what I'm hoping, is that I see people have access to it, so I don't think late assignments are going to make much of a difference, but.
It says resubmit.
You got a what?
It says resubmit assignment.
Oh, sure. So maybe your original is zero. We don't care about that. Okay, good. That's a good start.
Yes.
So now, I go.
Oh, right. Fantastic.
On your home page.
So, okay, so yeah, if you go in to resubmit, then you should be able to do it. Has anybody been to
submit? Did
you submit?
Oh, where's the assignment?
Go into Active Teaching Labs course.
Yeah, I'm gonna do it in a minute, but I don't see it.
So scroll up a little.
On the homepage, there should be a little link.
It's before we start, no, yeah, there it is. I don't know why it's there, yeah. Yeah, it's linked in the before we start.
It's right on the homepage. I was looking down.
No, no, it just says you are turned it in at 1:02.
So what happened?
I don't know.
Yeah, I think that that's one thing I think I'm observing is if you're late, it automatically switches you to resubmit assignment instead of just submit assignment. This is what I'm discovering, it seems.
What happened?
When I looked at what I already submitted, it was the most.
Oh, funny. So, this is the first time we're trying this. I have been trying to get in as a student, but because of my sub-admin account privileges, I couldn't. So this is untested. You guys are the guinea pigs.
I'm just getting submitted assignment.
So I went to here, this box, and just text entry. Where'd you go?
Did you click on these? Not assigned. Why isn't it assigning them?
Well, it hasn't been done yet. They have to turn it in. Or you have
she
all
has
that,
turned
right?
it in, yeah.
Okay, here, let's see.
Does everybody have to turn it in?
I can do text entry.
No.
Can just do it automatically after
yeah,
these days?
Let's see how it's set up.
That's what I'm doing.
You didn't set the time for when to assign the use.
Well, that's because it says it must come after due date if this blanket uses the due date, so I figured it didn't need to. But let's put in 1 o'clock.
Is everybody done?
Oh, although I don't know that it's gonna let you change anything.
Oh, it doesn't allow doc files, I thought
it did. I thought it did too.
Doc X. I have a doc X.
Ooh.
So
will you update that too? Doc to doc.
Or do you
X.
Want to just leave
here,
doc
he's
X.
Adding it. There you go. It's been added. Now will it let you?
See, yeah. It does that. I cannot figure out what that means.
Now, if you click continue, it won't let you go forward. It won't.
Would you like to go back and include X?
No, because you don't want to include all the others. We only want the groups that are here in there. This is what See, and I'm not trying to assign it to a group. This is a very odd situation here. I don't know what's going on.
Okay, so those are the groups.
Right. And everyone here is in one of those groups. I don't want to assign it to the people who aren't here, right? Does that make sense?
Yeah, you should be able to continue and just
no,
let it
won't searching for something. Try continue.
Oh, okay. I think I get it. So what group are they in?
One or two.
Are they in the active teaching lab? Group one and group two.
Yeah.
What's the over?
Active teaching lab,
yeah.
Okay. Oh, so you have to include the umbrella group as well?
Yeah, you have to include the umbrella group, I think. So let's try it out.
Okay. Ruined your perfect record. Catherine?
Let's just make it everyone.
So, John, I'm going to make confirmation that I submitted this with an operation.
You should get confirmation that you submitted it at the top.
Does anybody know if that's a student?
I can comment on it.
Yeah, that's what I was saying. Is she in the
act?
Oh, no, I did.
Oh, you did, yes.
Just popped up. There's just not a name on it. There's this.
Just that.
So what if we manually assign?
You can do that.
Well,
so I want to demonstrate. So let's say in everyone.
Wait, where's the rubric?
It's not as different. What question is have they said? That's
what I want to say.
Okay.
Go back. Okay. Now, can you hit reload to make.
Maybe it's my two assignments.
Right.
You got that? Oh.
I assigned it to everyone in the active teaching lab, and then it worked.
It's a good lesson to learn, so there might be some really wrong things going on. Not sure about.
That's all.
So now people are getting.
Yes.
Yeah, so there's 19 submissions in here so far. Is that everybody, you think?
You can sign it.
Okay, so what I'll do now is, now that we're all in, I'll go in here and go to edit. I think this will work.
Really?
We'll see. Just go here.
All right, yeah.
Oh, you checked, this is a group assignment, that's why. That's what happened. You checked, this is a group assignment. As they're doing it in groups. You shouldn't do that, this is an individual assignment. You only do that if groups of students together are grading something. And the reason it was barking at you is because you were saying, you were assigning it to group one, and so, and then group two, and those were like people that were supposed to hand it in.
Okay.
All right.
So now, it won't let you change it though now, will it?
We'll see. Yeah, I can't change group settings.
Yeah, once somebody's done something, they don't like it.
So some of you already though have it showing up as a, please review this, right?
Yeah, but it links back to that single submission, it's the most recent.
All right, so everybody can answer one or two of those submissions, right?
Yeah, it goes back to.
All right.
We can't write in the group.
Oh, so.
I'm assigned.
All right. So group to Canvas is something very different.
So I wonder if what's gonna happen here is as you all review it, it will overwrite itself over and over again. Or.
So we can't write on the group.
I think you can. Let's see what you can.
You can manipulate sections when it first creates.
Yeah, see, this is the issue that I saw.
They have like slight. Right.
Yeah, I know. Most of them can. I remember the rubric. Now, there might be something really funky with how the groups are
specific. But sections has more to do with CIS.
You know, we could make another assignment.
Whereas, I mean, and the thing is, like, something like you can use groups to do, sections can have groups do what you can't use groups to do. Something like that.
Sure.
Good learning experience here.
Okay, there we go. So if you go to, go back, John, to the other one. If you go to peer reviews, it shows everyone who is assigned and whether they finished their peer review or not.
I know, Chris Van.
So nice job, Sid.
I did it somewhere.
John, do I show up in there because I'm one of those eager beavers who turned my finger?
Go ahead, make it.
I got that one too.
I thought so.
We thought we were so clever.
Yeah.
So we can.
There you are. Yes.
So those are the ones that.
Yuyan hasn't graded yours yet.
Okay, where do I
wait,
see my other
so, one? Wait, no, those are who are assigned to her.
Mm-hmm. Right.
Not who's grading her.
Except because all the same thing.
Well, they're assigned
yeah, Ruth,
to
it's Ruth Olson's assignment,
and Meg.
And Yuyan and Meg are assigned
so
to look at it.
So Ruth would be graded by someone else.
Rubric doesn't tell me what.
Oh, I
not necessarily.
It's really two different
oh.
Students,
right? Yeah. So what's under those names are who they have to grade.
Got
yes.
It.
Right.
Let me see if I have
a
I think that's
decent.
So there's one,
and
I
threw.
Right.
I go back to the this.
Oh, those are different names.
Yeah.
Mine is the same way, but
it's cool.
She just put me in.
Okay. What do you
say? We have two identical submissions.
Can you give a different name? Two different student names on the same submission.
That's weird.
Somebody cheated.
Well,
oh,
it's, probably,
Angela, Catherine.
It's probably due to the group no. thing.
I know. Yeah, that's what it is. It's the group thing.
Well, good. I'm glad I did that because if
this
I was doing this, exactly, I would think it would be about groups, not about A's.
Position then, like, just
that's what I'm not, what I don't understand is why it changes every time.
It probably updates the last person who submitted.
Right.
That's the one that sees.
Maybe.
Yeah.
So, to see my... Well, I should just...
To see the ones that people gave with you. That's a good question, too.
So I have the two names of the people's
pieces. All right, we're going to try it second time. We're going to try it again. So we're going to give you guys a new assignment.
Tim's grading right now.
I can see how this is done in real time.
I'm not done.
What
do you go to your grades?
So instead of the learning experience, it's going to be a teaching experience.
All right. And text entry. Huh.
Let's just make it all text entry.
Automatically assign peer reviews.
Where do I see my peer reviews as a student?
Assign everyone.
Should be on the left hand side.
And I'm going to give you.
Yeah, if you refresh here, it should be on your to do list. So if you go to the home page.
No, he wants to see what people gave him for feedback.
Right, but your to do list will show up on the home page.
Oh, that's
a little
button.
Yeah. Anyway, nobody gave me feedback.
So what if you go to group one? Since it's set up as a group assignment.
Did anyone review me?
I don't think they know.
I was late, so I probably suffered.
Okay, there's a new assignment. You have 5 minutes to do it, and then that. Okay, most memorable teaching experience.
So where should they go to find this?
Then if you go to assignments, you should see it listed.
It showed up and then it disappeared.
Right.
It showed up and went away.
Oh, I
know why. Is it published?
Yeah, I gotta publish it. Hey! So it's the second list. One, that's
due at 1:20. Let's do it 1:20, so you have 5 minutes to do it.
Anybody know how to find it?
There isn't one for this assignment. Maybe I should make one.
No rubric for this assignment.
No rubric.
Have to make it all up.
It's there.
Yeah.
Thanks for coming.
One of the really interesting things from last Friday that Miguel talked about was he requires all of his students to do the text entry. So they can create it in Word, but then they have to copy and paste it as a text entry thing. Because he says he's got 400 students, and every time that they submit a Word doc or PDF, when he goes to grade it, Canvas does that little spinny thing as it converts it from PDF into that editable format. So he says, I'm just going to have them submit it as a text entry, and it's immediately there. So he figures he's saving all kinds of time where for every student it would be spinning.
Yeah.
So instead of having it spin for all the students, it's just there all immediately.
Okay, now you'll be able to give them the assignment and do it.
I still have not assigned.
They're still typing. Maybe hit refresh and give it another go.
4 minutes left. Mm-hmm. Now you know exactly how your students feel.
Yeah, this is.
Submit assignment. So they won't show up here on the day.
Yeah, you submit and then it should
be shown up. I submitted my assignment.
In this mysterious box here.
Yeah. Okay, there's four submissions right now.
Okay, let's turn it where's your comment
calendar? Both are submitted via some of those box open here.
So now where will I get my peer review?
Think right here.
So if you go to you can see right now that they're still not assigned to anybody. Mm-hmm. Now, does this wait until 1:20?
Yes.
Before it goes
at 1:21, it will assign peer review.
Cool.
So if anybody's done and has questions, other questions they want to know.
How were you able, the previous screen, were you able to see how many, you said four people have submitted it? Were you seeing names or were you seeing
no,
the
just
number?
People. So if I go...
If you go to the grade book, though, you can see that.
Yeah, another thing you can do, so there's 8 submissions now, and if you go to SpeedGrader, you can see everybody's name, who's all submitted.
Have you ever tried putting the review submit date in advance of the...
It won't let you do it.
Right.
It
doesn't
yeah,
let you
I don't
do
like
it.
That.
Yeah, if you're trying to put the review in ahead of the submit, it says you can't get out of the mouth. I don't know.
Is there a way to have them review as soon as it gets turned in, so they get notified as soon as it gets turned in? Or do they have to wait for a certain time?
I think as soon as it gets turned in, yeah, you can have it automatically assigned. I think so.
If you don't put any due date, it will automatically assign as soon as the due date is reached.
As soon as it's turned in or as soon as
no, as soon as the due date is reached.
Well, what if you don't put a due date?
Well, then you'll never have, you will never assign.
It will never do.
Yeah.
All right.
That's the problem. So if you want to stage it, yeah, so we have to make a pre-assignment and then a draft. And then another assignment in a second.
Yeah, you definitely have to do that.
Can the student...
So that's actually a feature I'd like to see, yes?
Can a student... Where will the student go to see which one they...
Okay, so I can show you that once it assigns that. So everybody got theirs in? By my clock, you have...
1 minute.
20 seconds. I know, like the suspension is. We tried to make the act of teaching that suspenseful.
Oh, yeah. Okay, 120.
Okay, it is 120, and a minute later, it should assign peer reviews. There's no sign yet.
Okay. That's it. But we won't see where, we'll see who's assigned to ours, but where will we see which peer review we're assigned to?
If you go to the home page, on the left side, you'll see the to-do list.
Right side.
The right side?
The right side. Passenger side?
Submission turned in.
Yes.
Assigned to peer reviews.
And then under assigned peer reviews, you might have to refresh in a minute. I don't know.
So the when you have someone peer reviewing your assignments, their names always show?
You can set it so that the peer reviews are anonymous if you'd like.
But the instructor does that, not the student?
The instructor does that, yes.
I don't know why.
Sorry. I can't grade because when I do the rubric,
all right, it's 121. Your assignments are in. Your peer review assignments are assigned.
They are all assigned.
If you go to your homepage on the right side, there should be something review about peer review assignments. Yeah, three.
So when you click on one of them, is it going to be assigned to the other or is it
someone else? Work on your little phones.
I've heard that the Canvas app is very good on your iPhone or your Android.
So it might be on the bottom. Right on the bottom. On a small
screen.
Yeah,
actually, all right. I'm about to take this. Did you have control?
Yeah.
So is that someone else's assignment?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah.
Yes. Oh, it's not. This one didn't come up on our homepage.
To do peer review.
So
I've
popped a peer review, but it doesn't give me a
place.
Just click on the blue, your first one, and that should open up the peer review thing.
That's mine. I don't see.
Because we did not have a rubric
for the second assignment, there is no place
I want to redesign all of that.
but you can't give points at all.
No, and that's okay, because the students can't give points, they can't add grades anyway. So if you have a rubric, you can get your point values via the rubric, but they can't give you, you know, A plus paper.
The points are really just for the students.
That's my son.
That's your son.
So the same thing.
Right.
So just Paustian?
So even if you have a review, have a rubric, and you have the students grade each other on a rubric, they may not get the grade that they were given by the other students, because that rubric grade is meaningless until the instructor puts it in.
So really, that's 4 points. You should always have a rubric, because otherwise the student can't get what they think the points are. Is that correct?
Unless you say, give them the points that you out of 20 and explain why. But yeah, rubrics are a good idea.
Unless you're just giving them feedback.
Yeah, just that time for one answer. Right. But I know I almost always, if I have students do any kind of cut, anything like this, they've got to have a rubric or guidelines. And so that's really important.
So if you didn't open-ended one, then the instructor would give the points, and they would just have the students' comments in there. So if I went into this as an instructor, then the student would have given feedback, and then you as an instructor would give the final points.
Yeah, so if I go back to micro 527, I can show you what...
But that happens even if you give them rubrics to use.
Right, you still give them the final points.
Yeah, so I go back to my dashboard.
I wasn't very excited.
I gave you feedback.
My feedback was exciting.
Mine, no, yours was exciting.
What were you able to assign the grade?
It's my best grammar joke.
Yeah, your best grammar joke.
Oh, great. Are we still doing the reviews?
If you want.
I don't know how to assign the grade.
Yeah, me either.
So you can't assign a grade,
because there was no
rubric assigned to the second thing.
Yeah, so if
so
I go to...
How come then when I look at my own assignment, I still grade for it? Is it because the teacher didn't have it?
For the first assignment?
No,
really?
I didn't know.
Did you get
it? Okay, so here's an example from my class. And this shows someone using a speed grader. So you can see all the comments that they added. Things that they changed, et cetera, et cetera. Here's the assessment by Benjamin Grob and what he did. And then you can see the grade he gave it, which was 6 out of 10.
So how could he give it that grade? I thought
you said. Oh, actually, no, I'm sorry.
Okay.
Here's the grade that he gave it.
Okay.
18 out of 30 on the rubric.
Right, huh?
Then what I would do is I'd look at what he put, which was 18 out of 30. And then I think there's another student on here. Yeah, he'll go out. And I look at what he did, and he does 11.5 out of 30, so I kind of split the difference. This person did do a very good job, and I agreed with that. I gave him a 6 out of, then I put in the score here.
You put in the score.
I put the score here, and then it gets immediately put into the grade book.
Go ahead.
So you have to flick back and forth to see the two different peer reviews. So Canvas cannot show you both at the same time, so you can compare?
And not in my experience, no.
Okay.
You could use two tabs.
You could do that.
But the second they hit their peer review, the student sees what they gave them, unless you put, you can also put in that masking thing too. So
yeah, you can put it, you can do that, that says no grades get released until you say so.
And then they wouldn't see yours or the other students.
Yeah, they won't see yours or the students until you've all reviewed it.
Can you go to the grade book in our Active Teaching Lab one?
Okay.
This is curious, because some grades have been assigned.
I did it.
You did it. All right.
What?
Duncan is upset that he didn't get 4 out of 4. So add your office hours. He's going to come in and talk to you about how to get that extra point.
What's a T?
Text submission.
Okay,
so
if you scroll all the way to the right, it's the... Yeah, there you go.
Okay, so we'll fix Duncan's grade right now.
There you go.
Okay. now I won't come to my office hours, so I'm
Yes, I see that.
How does she do it manually? Are you
You know, one thing that was hilarious about Canvas when I was first learning it, it took me hours to realize you could click on this and just put the score in. I looked at all sorts of stuff, I couldn't find out how to do it, and it's like, oh man.
Any other questions in the last 2 minutes here? I know there are lots of questions and we're not going to be able to answer them all. But if there are any burning ones.
I would like to say though, everybody's enrolled as a student right now so that we could do this. And when we switch you back to a teacher, all of it will be lost.
All of your grades.
But
all of your submissions.
It just got people.
But it makes more sense to have you all as teachers because most of the things that we do in this lab are about learning how to set it up as an instructor. So I will be switching you all back to teachers and all of this will be lost. It will be like a demo.
I would like to thank you all for participating in this experiment. This is actually by the psychology department. Please help me thank Tim for coming and sharing his experiences. And thank you for working with this, working through this with us. Please fill out this evaluation and come next Friday. We're going to talk about tips and tricks, things that we've learned this semester, and we'll have coffee and bagels for you in the morning.
Thank you.
Thank you guys.
Yes, you will.